Okay, in this video, I'll show you guys how to find the arc length formula of a polar curve going from theta 1 to theta 2. And the key to do this is that be sure you give this video a like. Thank you. Anyway, here's the deal. We are given a polar equation, r is a function of theta, and we know we can actually go from polar equation to a parametric equation very easily. And because we know how to find the arc length when we have parametric equations, so we will go to the parametric equation and deal with that right over there. So here we go. Let me show you how to go from polar to parametric equation. And we can always make this happen easily. Not all the parametric equations can be written in terms of polar equations easily, but we can always go from here to here easily. To do so, we have to remember, okay, let's get the x and y equations. And x is r times cosine theta, but this time r is a function of theta, so we'll write that down. So we have r of theta, and we just multiply by cosine theta for the x component. And for the y, we do the same thing, r of theta, but here we multiply by sine theta for the y component. And we'll just find the parametric equation by using the And we'll just find the arc length with the parametric equation right here. And of course, we are using theta for our parameter. And here is the dl. Let me write down dl for this. dl means the small change in the arc length. And this right here is just that you make a small little segment, and you can use the Pythagorean theorem. And it's just going to be the square root. And you have to look for this small change in the x and square that, and you add it with the small change in y and square that. And let me write it down right here for you guys. Well, we will have to differentiate this with respect to theta. So I will just put this down as dx d theta. And we have to square that. And we have to add. Right here, we will have to differentiate this with respect to theta. So dy d theta square. And in this situation, we will have the d theta on the outside. This right here is our length formula part for the parametric equation. Of course, you have to integrate. But let's look at this first. And of course, I have a video on this already, so be sure you guys go check that out if you haven't seen that already. Anyway, here is the deal. We just have to do the dirty work, namely find the derivative. Yeah. All right, here we go. Dx d theta. This is a function of theta times cosine theta. Yes, we will have to use the product rule. Anyway, I will keep the first function, and for simplicity purpose, I will just write down r, all right? And we multiply by the derivative of the second, which is going to give us negative sine theta. And we add the second function, which is cosine theta, and we have to multiply by the derivative of the first. And let me write down the dr d theta notation right here, right? So that's pretty much the idea. And we square that right here because of that. And then we continue. We add dy d theta, which is, of course, the product rule again. Keep the first function, and again, for simplicity purpose, I'll just write down r. And the derivative of sine theta is cosine theta, and we add the second function is sine theta, and we multiply by the derivative of the first, which I will just write down as dr d theta. And we have to square that, and we have the d theta on the very outside. Okay, so let's see what we have right here. We will have to expand this. So check this out. This is the binomial inside. So here we have this square, which is positive r squared. Let me just write everything down in red. R squared times sine squared theta. And we have to add, well, technically subtract, because this right here is negative, right? So we have to technically subtract 2 times this and that. So we have 2r sine theta cosine theta dr d theta, like this. And the last part right here, we will have to add cosine square theta, and then we have to have the dr d theta square, like this, right? And the truth is, everything will be in the square root, but I don't have enough space, so I will just put down the bigger square root, and then we'll just keep adding. All right, so that was the first part, and now let's look at the second part. The first part was in red, right here, and now for the second part. Okay, here we go. We just go ahead and add. And we have r squared cosine square theta, And we have to do 2 times this and that as well. So it's plus 2 times r cosine sine and that. So let me just put down sine theta first and then cosine theta next. And then we have the dr d theta. And we have the last part plus sine. In this case, we have the sine square theta. And again, dr d theta square. This right here is not a second derivative. This means you find the first derivative and you square that. And everything right here is inside. And of course, it's the bad notation. This has nothing to do with the fraction. It's just that I don't have enough space to write down everything this long, right? OK, here's the deal. This and that, it's actually very nice. Because we can actually factor out the r square. And this is very nice. R square times sine square theta plus cosine square theta, yes, this is just 1 right here, isn't it? So the first part inside is just r squared. So I'll just put that down for you guys. Let me write down the equal sign here. R squared all the way right here, right? Cool. How about this guy? Yes, very nice. Cancel, cancel. They are gone. How about this guy? Well, again, we can do that. We can factor out the dr d theta and then square, right? So it's the first derivative square, like this. And we have the cosine square theta plus sine square theta. Of course, here we will end up with 1 right here as well. So in other words, we just have this part. So actually, I don't have to write down this long. So we just have to add the first derivative, dr d theta, and then we square that. And this is the d theta. So here's the deal. dl is this, which is that in the r and theta world, right? And of course, to integrate this, you will have to put down whatever the given function is into here and differentiate that with respect to theta and then put it here and square and all that. But anyway, this is not the r length here. This is just the dl. So we have to integrate both sides. Let me just put this down for you guys to be legitimate. L is equal to, this is just a small piece of the length, which is r, and we square the r, and we look at the derivative with respect to theta, and we square that d theta. And we have to add up all of the such lengths, and you go from theta 1 to theta 2, and we are done. Very nice. Very nice. So this right here, it's a proof, right? So I did prove this for you guys now, right? So in class, I don't prove it, but now I do. And it's your homework as well. Anyway, this is it.